Okay, here we go. We're going to go back and review a little bit on our blind contour and then go through modified contour. So, hello. Okay, so looking at our blind contours, remember we had a few important details about the blind contour. It's going to look crazy. It is one continuous line, which means you're never going to lift up your pencil. It will still be very detailed, so we're going to see all the bumps and creases of your finger. You're going to see the fingernails. You're going to see how things bend. But as you're not looking at your paper, it's just going to go on top of each other. It's going to be ridiculous. It is a line drawing, so there's not going to be shading, and you never look at your paper. We are trying to separate what your brain knows and what your eyes see, so you're actually drawing what you see and not what your brain knows. Because remember, that gives you those rubbery fingers. It's that schema that's in your brain. It's like, oh, I know what a hand looks like. We're trying to make sure your eyes do the work. So this is just one of those training exercises. So I heard someone compare it to the things like if you're in a sport and you would do these drills, these exercises in order to get better. Let's think of this in that same way. So now let's jump to our modified contour. So in modified contour, we're going to make a couple changes. One thing is going to stay the same, which is it's going to be a continuous line. It's still going to be a single line, and you're never going to lift up your pencil. It will still be very detailed, so I'm still going to look for those bumps and creases and things going through, but I'm going to look at my paper when my pencil is not moving. So it's still going to look a little bit crazy, but it's going to be more detailed. So we're going to do that part together. So let me jump over to a fresh page. And I'm going to do my hand in a pose. And I'm going to think of this as an 80-20 rule, meaning I'm going to look at my object 80% of the time, and 20% of the time I'm going to be looking at my paper. That will prevent me from drawing that schema or that image, that picture of my brain, and instead I'll be drawing the picture from my eyes. So 80% of the time I am looking, 20% of the time I'm looking at my paper and I'm drawing there. So let's do this first. So I'm going to start with just peace sign. All right, so anytime you have straight fingers, it makes it a little bit more difficult because it's hard to see those angles. If you curve them a little bit, you can start to see how things bend and curve, and it's actually a little bit easier. So I'm going to change from my open peace sign, which is tricky, to something curved because it's a lot easier. All right, so I still start. I'm putting my hand off to the side so I'm not looking. I'm turning myself away, and I'm putting my pencil down, and I'm just going to continue to draw. So I'm starting one place. I'm going over the back side of the knuckles. I'm going on an angle up, and I see the first curve increase. And I'm going to stop and check. And then I'm going to draw a little bit more. Stop and check. Draw some more, and I'm stopping. So anytime I look at my paper, I stop my pen from moving. And I can check as many times as I want, but the goal is that every time I take a look, oh, where am I? Okay. And notice how sometimes things are still off, and that's okay. Draw over some of these lines. Anytime I want to take a peek, I just stop drawing. Because I want that information to come from my eyes and not come from my brain. So I'm just doing little adjustments as I stop and check. And notice how it's looking a lot more realistic than my blind contour looked, but it's still a little bit wonky. All right, so I'm just going to speed up a little bit just for the sake of time for this video. But notice what you can tell when I stop and I look at the paper because my pencil stops moving. And that is the biggest part about the blind contour. Most of the time, I'm looking at my paper. Or I'm sorry, I'm looking at my object, not my paper. Now, the best thing about this as I'm drawing that is that things start to look more realistic and information comes from my eyes. And as I train my eyes to do the work, my hand will just follow and I become a better artist. And that is the goal of doing all of these exercises so that you can learn to actually draw what you really truly see and things get more realistic. So let's follow our 80-20 rule for our modified. So remember, this is our modified contour. We're going to do some of these, post these to our slides. I am stopping and checking. So I stop drawing to check the paper. All right, try those, post those to your next things.